and the Greater Dayton Area League of Women Voters presents Meet the Candidates, your chance to learn about the candidates running for office in the November election.
Hi, I'm Patty Skilkin. I'm a member of the League of Women Voters of the Greater Dayton Area, and I'm here to interview Mr. Robert Kleppinger, who's running for the 10th Congressional District. Mr. Kleppinger has two opponents, neither of which could be here today, David Harlow and Mike Turner. So we're just going to get to talk to Mr. Robert Kleppinger, and he'll tell you a little bit about yourself. Why am I stuttering? The 10th Congressional District covers all of Greene and Montgomery County and part of Fayette County. Robert, why don't you start out by giving a little brief description of why you're running, who you are?
My name is Robert Kleppinger. I'm 46 years old. And for the past 20 years, I've been a high school chemistry teacher. The reason I'm here, I guess I got tired of yelling at the TV. I want to make a positive change for the people who live in our district. I want to see their wages increase. I want to see the minimum wage increase. I just want to do good. I want to participate in politics. And I saw that opportunity. I called the lady at the local Democratic County office and asked her if they had an opponent for Mr. Turner, and she said no. So here I am.
This Congress has probably the lowest approval rating ever in history. The last number I heard was something like 7%, has passed the least amount of legislation than any Congress in history. They're being criticized wildly. Can one person do anything about that? What do you think the problem is? How do you feel about that?
Well, the problem is we keep electing the same people. We need different people in there. I would agree with you. One of my major issues with the 113th Congress is that in the House of Representatives, they voted, 50 or 54 times to repeal the president's health care plan? If you would allow me, Albert Einstein defined insanity as doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. How can you justify that? That's why the approval of rating is so low. I mean, in my own personal opinion, they haven't done anything but try to make the President of the United States look bad. That, to me, has been the goal of the 113th Congress, especially the House of Representatives.
Okay, let's talk about the environment.
Yes.
A lot of scientists think we're getting close to the tipping point on being able to keep the planet habitable. How do you feel about climate change, global warming, fracking, renewable energy sources, the whole ball of wax? I don't want to make it easy.
Oh, no. Actually, I prepared myself 18 note cards, and I, honest to goodness, I think I have an answer for everything with a quote. This quote is from Marcus Aurelius. That which is not good for the beehive cannot be good for the bees. I'm a high school chemistry teacher. When I went to Wright State, I was one class and two labs away from a BA in chemistry. I know what science is. Science is really, really simple. It's the scientific method that you learned in junior high or middle school. Scientists, they don't make things up. You know, they have a method for looking at a problem. They have a method for collecting data. And if 98% of the scientists out there says that global warming is happening, I would agree with them. Yeah, it's probably happening. The other 2% of the scientists, maybe they work for an oil company. I don't know. But yes, there is change happening to the earth. And we, as politicians, have to do the right thing for the earth. We need to keep our earth habitable. I'm not a fan of fracking. I just heard a friend of mine told me that in West Virginia they plan on fracking underneath the Ohio River. You know, that cannot be good for the Ohio River. We must, again, focus on doing what's best for the earth, because there's no plan B. There's nowhere else to go. This is our home.
Thank you. Let's talk about women. We're a huge voting bloc. You could probably say whoever gets the female vote is probably going to win the election. We tend to outlive men, so there's more of us. What do you think could be in your personal campaign platform that would appeal the most to that voting bloc, to women?
Well, I think the first and foremost thing that's been in the news lately is equal pay for equal work. I know the Senate looked at this, and it was totally dismissed by the Republican Party. I don't see why they can't do it. In education, I'm a high school teacher. We have a salary schedule. It's based on the amount of education that you have and how many years experience you have. And I don't see why, you know, a major corporation, say, I don't know, pick one, say General Electric, if they have 100 vice presidents, why they couldn't have that for both genders. I mean, just have, you know, if you're a vice president with 5 years experience, you make X amount of dollars. You know, I realize that there are bonuses and things like that for people who perform well, but I'm a strong supporter of equal pay for women.
Good. The movement Move to Amend, which is referring to the Citizens United, the Supreme Court decision, corporations are people. The Move to Amend movement is starting to gain some traction. How do you feel about that? Do you have a position? Which side would you be on?
I wrote over 300 letters trying to solicit campaign donations for my run for Congress, and I got nothing back from anyone. I mean, I wrote to all the big corporate donors that donated to my opponent. It's not a fair system. I mean, I just don't have the means or the funds to get on TV, well, except for our program here today, and I appreciate you so much, Patty. Thank you. But no, it's simply not fair. I mean, it's a matter of, you know, whoever has the most money is going to win. And I don't think the average everyday American can be adequately represented with the system that we have now.
If you're elected, what would your number one priority be? Your dream legislation?
I'd like to find a way for the people to have better paying jobs. Whether that would be, you know, to encourage companies to pay better by offering them better access to federal contracts, companies that didn't pay a living wage. Everybody beats up on Walmart. I guess I will too. They made $17 billion last year, and their average pay for their worker is $8 an hour with no benefits. That's not fair, I mean, in my opinion. Sure, they can do it. Sure, people will go work for them. But I can't see how anyone would support that. I support organized labor and what they stand for.
Thank you. I've been talking to Robert Kleppinger, who is running against David Harlow and Mike Turner for the 10th Congressional District. You've just heard his views on a variety of subjects. I want to thank you for being here today. It's been a pleasure talking to you and hearing your answers. The League of Women Voters is a nonpartisan organization. We never, ever support or oppose a candidate or a political party. We do, however, fight for voters' rights, and we encourage everybody to vote. If you're voting absentee, be sure and fill in the little circles. You'll get a little bubble. You have to fill it in. You can't make a check mark or an X. You have to fill in the little bubble with blue or black ink. Be sure and sign it and mail it in soon. If you have any questions about your polling places or anything else, you can call the League of Women Voters office at 228-4041, 228-4041. Thank you so much for being with us today.